Planet Aridia. This is a really cool level, guys. I really love the music on this stage. And this was one of the best looking levels on the PS4 version of this game. It was just so fantastic looking, man. It blew me away. Just seeing that in 1080p. Okay, so there's a couple of sections that we can go to on this planet. But we're going to go this way first. We're going to talk to this guy here, Skid McMarks.
It's him, Skid McMarks.
That man from the Infobot.
In the flesh, little dude. You guys get a load of that epic space battle I was in?
We saw you screaming for help.
That was like a war cry. My agent and I got ambushed on the way to hoverboard practice.
Did he survive the crash, sir?
He's okay. But I've had a little trouble getting back to my ship due to my sprained ankle.
Oh, come on.
If you can take out all the sand sharks, I just might have a spare hoverboard for you.
We'd love to help you, Mr. McMarks, but Ratchet and I need to find Captain...
One of your boards? I've always wanted a decent hoverboard. Well, all right. You just keep that foot elevated.
Okay, so we're gonna help out this dude here, Skid McMarks. The Pyrocitor is a really good weapon for this challenge. Because it just... The thing is, in this game, you can't strafe, so it's a little hard to safely attack the enemies, I guess we could say. And because the Pyrocitor attacks in a 360-degree angle, if you just use it and you spin around while you're walking, it's really easy to just kill all the enemies without getting into too much trouble, which is why this is one of the best weapons in this game. And it's just going to get even better when we get the upgrade of it, the Gold Pyrocitor. All these sand... What are they, sand sharks again? Yeah. Okay. Pretty easy enemies to beat. There's a lot of them, though, so attacking them with the wrench would be bad because you're gonna be a little too slow to hit all of them, so you're gonna be better off using a weapon on them. And this wall here, you can break this wall with the bomb glove, and there is a gold bolt over here. And there's also some ammo. Not bad. And there is some health as well, but I'm on full health, so I don't need that. You can upgrade your health later. Right now I have 4 hit points, but that's gonna change later on when I can buy the health upgrades. I guess we gotta go up here on top of this mountain. Okay. Let me make sure I have my Pyrocitor ready. I really like the sound effect when you whip this weapon out. Just listen to this, man. Yeah, and he makes a face, too. I actually just noticed that. Look at Ratchet's face when he whips out his weapon. He, like, has this really evil grin, like he's about to shit up, man. Really funny. Okay. Alright. Just destroying all these enemies with this weapon. So awesome. I love the sound effect, too, when you use the flames. It's like... Whoosh. It's really exaggerated and just really cool. Okay, we're up to the final section here. Just got 2 more of these things to destroy and also these sand sharks. Okay. Almost done. Alright, there are 3 more sand sharks somewhere. I don't quite know where. We're gonna find them in a second. Let me just get all these bolts. Alright, breaking the TNTs, that's straight out of Crash Bandicoot, right guys? Like I said, Insomniac and Naughty Dog, really good friends with each other, so they tend to borrow stuff. Wait, how did these sand sharks just appear out of nowhere? I'm pretty sure they weren't there when I was down there. Oh well.
Here, man, catch.
A brand new Z3000! You can't even buy these!
Well, I gotta bail. Catch you dudes at the hoverboard races.
You've just acquired. Okay, so now we have the hoverboard. We're gonna be able to use that to enter a race later on. Just gonna scrooge it up and pick up all these bolts, because yeah guys, in this first game here, bolts are a little tough to come by. Not as common as in Going Commando and in the other sequels. We're gonna have to play Going Commando on the channel at some point, guys, because that's my favorite Ratchet and Clank out of all of them. Like I said, man, Going Commando, just the amount of ways that they improved upon this first game here in Going Commando is ridiculous. You wouldn't even think of half the stuff that they came up with to improve on it. Like, they added arena fights so you could farm bolts and you could kill swarms of enemies. They added upgradable weapons, so your weapons, as you use them, they upgrade with experience. So the more enemies you kill with your weapons in Going Commando, you're going to be able to level up your weapons. And that was a really great idea. I didn't even think of that when I was playing this game for the first time. And honestly, there's really not much need to use your weapons in this game. So I'm just going to wrench it here and show you guys that there's just no difference from using a weapon as opposed to using your wrench. Because it's not too hard to kill these guys anyway. And if you don't use your weapon, you're conserving ammo and saving a bit of money in the long run, I guess. Not like I use my weapons too much anyway. I really try to wrench as many as I can. But yeah, guys, in Going Commando, like I said, you could upgrade your weapons. So that gave you more of a purpose in using the weapons and also leveling up the weapons and getting them more powerful. That was when they really went full on with the RPG elements, because this game is mainly a platformer with action elements and shooter elements. Even though it is, like I said, many game elements built into one, this is still primarily a platform game, and they changed that in Going Commando where it was more of an action RPG. Yo, that music, man, I actually legitimately paused what I was saying to listen to the music there. That was a cool beat. I really love the music on this stage, guys. Okay, so here's the first swingshot puzzle. You basically just use the swingshot to swing from each of these floating whatever, the floating thingamabobs that you use your swingshot to swing to and fro through. Okay.
You can use the right arrow.
We're just freaking Spider-Maning our way all over this place. Yeah, Ratchet doesn't Superman his hose, he Spider-Mans his hose. To quote Soldier Boy. I don't even know why I'm quoting Soldier Boy, but we are. Okay, guys. There's actually a skill point you can get in this area for swinging from swingshot to swingshot without falling onto the floor, so I'm going to try to get that skill point. It's coming up in a little bit. Yeah, you don't need the swingshot to get across this jump. You can actually long jump over there. If you fall, though, you're f***ed because there's nothing but tar down there. Look, I'm going to show you guys. Yeah, if you fall down there, you're going to die. So you might be safer just using the swingshot. And this is where the skill point is, so I'm going to try to get it. Basically, you just swing from swingshot to swingshot and you don't fall down. And there we go. I did it, guys. So let's keep going here. Let's proceed. We're going to get the trespasser here, actually. This is one of my favorite gadgets. Okay, so we got the trespasser. We can use this to open doors. And a quick thing to note, guys, you can actually jump down here and there's a gold bolt. So yeah, the trespasser is a gadget that opens doors, and every Ratchet and Clank game has a gadget that opens doors, and the trespasser is actually my favorite out of the bunch because it's a really fun puzzle when you use it. You gotta like line up the laser beams to the arrows and stuff. It's a really good puzzle. Makes you think a little bit. In the other Ratchet and Clank games, the gadgets you get to open the doors, those are more based on reflexes and pressing buttons at the right time and stuff like that. And I don't know, those were a little boring to me. I much prefer using this one, the trespasser. Okay, so we're back to this area here. Now we can go to the other section. As you noticed before, there was a branching path, but I didn't go that way. Okay. I'm gonna just use the blaster on him, because why not? Alright, he just jumped right in front of me. He was asking to get wrenched to death there. Alright, yeah, you can also do combos with your wrench if you do the hyper strike, and then you do the wrench throw, like right there, as I demonstrated. Not bad. If you can combo with the wrench, it's always good. We're just gonna blaster this guy, because I'm on this conveyor belt, and I don't want to get messed up by his flamethrower there. Yeah, I can't wait till we get the taunter guys, because It's getting a little tedious trying to break all these boxes manually with the wrench. I guess I could break them with the pyrocitor if I wanted to, but I don't want to waste ammo for no reason. Man, the music in this level is just so awesome. The guy who composed the music in this game is a guy called David Burgode, and he did the music for all the Ratchet and Clank games. At least the PS2 ones, I'm sure. He even did Deadlocked, which is kind of like a part 4 to Ratchet and Clank, but it's not a main game, it's a spin-off game. And he also did the music for the first Future game, I believe. Future Tools of Destruction, which is the very first Ratchet and Clank game to come out on PS3. But I don't know, guys, the Future series wasn't quite as good as the original series. Yeah, I'm gonna be that guy, guys. I know Ratchet and Clank fans out there, I don't mean to, like, try to pick favorites, but... because I do like all the games, actually. I don't have a problem with the Future series, I just feel like it was way more imaginative in this series here, the original trilogy. Yeah, actually, guys, comment down below. What's your favorite trilogy for Ratchet and Clank is, if you're a PS2 trilogy guy or if you're a Future trilogy guy. Crack in Time was a really good game, actually. I don't know if I'm going to play that on the channel, but Crack in Time, guys, that was a really good game. I really enjoyed there's like a flying mechanic in that game where you can fly from planet to planet and fly from moon to moon, and you actually fly around in space. It was a really cool mechanic there. Okay, so there's a goal bolt over there. This is how you get it. You just long jump with the helipack and you jump onto this platform and we just go over here and we get a goal bolt, guys. Pretty simple stuff. If you try to jump across the tar normally to try and get this, you're gonna die because you're allowed to fall in the tar 3 times before you sink, and you don't want that to happen. I actually haven't died yet on the Let's Play, guys. Maybe we can keep that up. I'm gonna try my best not to die. I did fail a ton on the fitness course, but I didn't die, so yeah, we got a chance to make this a perfect run, a no-death run. I don't know if we're gonna manage it, but I'm gonna try. And over here, actually, we need the Magna Boots to go up here. I can't climb up this wall yet. And here is Skid's agent.
No signal whatsoever! This downtime is killing me!
Do you need medical attention, sir?
Don't be so literal, son. The problem is I'm stranded on this backwater planet and my star client is nowhere to be found.
Hey, we saw you on that info bot. You're Skid's agent.
Was Skid's agent. Haven't seen him since our ship crashed. And an agent without a client is like a flea without a dog.
An agent without a client is like a flea without a dog. He just totally roasted himself there, man. He compared himself to a freaking flea. What the hell? Yeah, the humor in these cutscenes, man. I just really love their sense of humor. It's really good. And of course, they toned it down a little bit in the remake. So they made the jokes not as funny. They made them more kid-friendly. Going Commando, though. Oh my god. I can't wait to play Going Commando because the cutscenes in that game are the best. It's the funniest Ratchet and Clank game for sure. Really gonna be a good time if I play Going Commando. But anyway, let's keep going here. We're going to the new planet. Let's go to Eudora. If you remember from the cutscene, we're gonna be going up against... what's his name? Or I guess they didn't say his name, but I guess we'll see him in this cutscene coming up here.
Yes, quite lovely. That should just about do it. Commander, we are finished with this world. Commence towing our planet to its next destination. Lieutenant!
Yes, sir?
You have fulfilled your tree quota. Barely.
We are ready to return to base.
Not so fast, Lieutenant. Just because we don't need any more trees doesn't mean they should have them. Destroy everything.
Damn, son. He is a real dick in this game, actually. I forgot about that. Even though he doesn't need any more trees for his planet, he's just gonna chop all of their trees down and leave them with nothing, man. That's savage. Okay, so we're on the new planet here. This is planet Eudora. There's a bunch of paths you can go. I'm not gonna go this way just yet. We're gonna go down this path, actually. And there's a new weapon we can buy in this shop. It's the... Glove of Doom, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, it is the Glove of Doom. cost 7,500 bolts to buy that. But actually, honestly, guys, I'm not going to buy any more weapons for a while because amongst the Bomb Glove, the Pyrocitor, and the Blaster, we have pretty much everything we need covered. These are the three starting weapons, and they're also the three best weapons in the game. Or at least they cover a wide enough amount of variety that you don't need any other weapons. Because we've got the Pyrocitor here. This is like the crowd control weapon. It's good against the smaller enemies. You've got the Blaster, which is the ranged option, and it's good against a lot of like tougher enemies that have a lot of health. And you've got the Bomb Glove, which is just good for killing a group of enemies really quickly. So we're going this way. Man, look at this planet. I really love the idea of this planet. It's like a really, really green-looking planet. It's got a lot of greenery and plant life, and these guys here, the Blargians, the enemies in the game, they're just trying to chop it all down, right? So we go over here and we get a gold bolt. You need to have the helipack to get this one. Yeah, man, the music is so catchy. I love the music on this planet. All the music in this game is good, but there are those couple of tunes that you really like to hum, right? This is one of them for me. I like this theme a lot. Okay. Fighting a bunch of smaller enemies, so I'm gonna get them with the Pyrocitor. I could just get them with the wrench, but it's not like we're at an ammo deficit right now, so it doesn't really matter. Might as well just have some more fun with this weapon that's really badass. Whoosh! Like I said, guys, I love that sound effect. It's really cool. Really exaggerated, too. If I used a flamethrower in real life, I wouldn't imagine it to make sound effects like that. Oh, I actually didn't mention this. This little thing on the floor here, this is a sand mouse house, right? So once you do the first race with the hoverboard and you win the prize, you can go back and talk to Skid's agent, and he's going to give you the Sonic Summoner, which you can use to summon those little sand mouses out of those sand mouse houses. And they'll help you out a bit. They'll provide some cover fire for you when you're in a fight. They don't last very long, though. Honestly, it's not that useful. It's just, it's not bad to use, I guess, but it's not really that useful. Damn, I just killed him in one hit. I thought he was gonna have a little more health than that. And we got all these enemies. Like I said, I like the concept of this planet, how it's just like got all these trees and all this greenery, and these guys are trying to chop it all down. It's really messed up, man. I think we should show this game to this planet, to Greenpeace, and see what they have to say about that, right? Or imagine if you play this planet on Earth Day or something, like just be as anti-environmental as f***ing possible, right, guys? So yeah, this game is just got all this be mean to green instead of being pro-green or whatever, I don't know. All these bad things they're teaching us here, like chopping down trees and all of that and whatnot. All right, let's just ace all these enemies with the Pyrocitor. Okay. Yeah, man, I don't even know why they're chopping down all these trees. What is the purpose of that? Like, if you chop down a tree and then you take it to another planet and you plant it in the ground, is that gonna help? Or like, whatever their plan is, they're trying to build a planet with the parts of all these other planets. They're basically, what they're doing is they're detaching all the best parts of the other planets, and they're trying to build a planet like that, like a freaking jigsaw puzzle or whatever. I don't know the science behind that or whatever, but clearly that would never work in real life, but that's what they're doing in the game here. It's a pretty cool concept, actually. It's really funny. I like it. It's like the Frankenstein monster. They're just taking the best parts of all these things and they're putting it together into one thing that's supposed to be really good as the final product. But what actually happens in Frankenstein is that it didn't work out so well, and the final product was actually an abomination. So maybe that would happen if their planet was completed and they got all the best parts of all these other planets and they put them together and they ended up making like a Frankenstein planet. So yeah, I don't know what these Blargian guys are thinking about here. They definitely don't have their science in the right place. These guys are pretty annoying. They've got blasters, and they run around a lot. Really annoying to deal with. The Glove of Doom is actually really good against these enemies, but like I said, guys, you don't need to buy the Glove of Doom. We've got our trifecta here. We've got the Pyrocitor and the Blaster and the Bomb Glove. Pretty much all you need to beat the game. Later on, though, we're going to get better weapons. Like the Tesla Claw. That's actually, in my opinion, the best weapon in the game because it's basically just a bigger and badder Pyrocitor. Instead of using fire, it uses electricity, and it has a longer range, and it homes in on the enemies as well. Really damn good weapon, especially the gold Tesla Claw. That's the best weapon in the game, even better than the Rhino. And we're going to talk about the Rhino and all of that stuff later on as we get to it. I'm just giving you guys a bit of a sneak peek to what's coming up. Yeah, these parts where I'm being a little silent is actually not too bad in the concept of this game because, like I said, I really love the music. Oh, they actually... What the hell? They just gave me Glove of Doom ammo, but I don't even have the Glove of Doom, so why are they giving me ammo for a weapon I don't have? I don't know what the hell just happened there, guys. They gave me weapon ammo for the Glove of Doom when I haven't bought it yet. I don't know if that's a glitch or what, but it just happened, guys, and I caught it on camera, so... Yeah, take that. Okay. Alright, we're running the gauntlet here. We're fighting all these really big enemies. They're not too tough, though. And you can break these pipes to get some bolts. Yeah, I'm just gonna break these boxes with the Pyrocitor, because I can't be bothered to do it with the wrench and do it manually. We're actually going to get a new weapon very shortly. It's a pretty good weapon too, actually. It's not bad, but there's not much use for it when you have the Pyrocitor. I just made him shoot his friend there. Pretty cool. If you don't want to waste time, you can make them kill each other by having them line up and attack each other like a stack of dominoes. Alright, the Bomb Glove is probably better for this. Yeah, the Bomb Glove... Because you don't need to go in close with them. The Bomb Glove has some pretty good range. And there is the weapon right there, guys. We're going to get it in a second. It's the Suck Cannon. And it does not suck, despite the name. It's a pretty good weapon.
Sweet.
Okay, so we have the Suck Cannon now. And how this weapon works is you hold down the circle button and it's gonna make like a vacuum and it sucks up smaller enemies. You can't use it to suck up the bigger enemies. Like this guy right here, I'm gonna swallow him with the Suck Cannon. And that's gonna add to my ammo with the Suck Cannon. As you see on the side there, there's like a little bar showing me how much ammo I have. And you just press the circle button again and you fire the enemy out. So, really damn- Oh shit, I actually hit a plane there, or not a plane, a ship, by complete accident there. That was total luck. I was just showcasing the Suck Cannon. Okay. So now we're gonna go to this area. Oh man, that was close. I almost fell down there. So we need the trespasser to go in this door. Okay, this little puzzle here. I like thinking about these puzzles. It's really fun. Like in the other games, the other ones you get, like the Electrolyzer and the Trespasser and all of those, they revolve around having quick reflexes to do those, and it's just really easy and it's not very fun, it's very monotonous. Compared to the Trespasser, like I said, which is a different puzzle every time and it keeps you thinking. Alright, the music just got real wacky here. This is like some Looney Tunes music that just came up. Yeah, this is some kind of music I'd expect to hear. Like Wile E. Coyote was chasing down Roadrunner or something. And you just long jump across. Yeah, this is, like I said, playing very heavily on the platforming aspects of this game. Because this game is primarily a platformer at heart. But it does have other elements thrown in there. I think this is the final door that we need to open. pretty simple so far. We haven't gotten up to the tough trespasser missions yet. Once I get up to those, I'm gonna have to really think.